In this table, we want to look at similarities and differences in how the somatic and autonomic nervous systems innervate their targets, and then compare the sympathetic and parasympathetic to one another. So first off, let's start here at the top left. We've got our somatic nervous system, somatic motor nervous system. And that means we're going to have innervation of skeletal muscle fibers down here at the bottom. Now, these cell bodies are found in the CNS. Their axons project out into the periphery, and they directly innervate their target skeletal muscle fibers, typically in large groups. We would have branching here and innervation of alternate skeletal muscle fibers as well by this single motor neuron. Again, those four motor units that we talked about previously. At the target, our neurotransmitter is acetylcholine, and it binds to cholinergic receptors of the subtype referred to as nicotinic, right? And this is always stimulatory. When we look at the autonomic nervous system, right? So this would be visceral motor control. We have two divisions, the sympathetic division and the parasympathetic division. The sympathetic division has relatively short preganglionic fibers and longer postganglionic fibers. Again, comparing to somatic, we now have a two neuron system that heads into the periphery here, right? The preganglionic fiber cell body is found in the CNS. Extends to the ganglion, which is usually found very close to the vertebral column. There we release the neurotransmitter acetylcholine onto nicotinic cholinergic receptors and then cause activation of our postganglionic fibers. These fibers release norepinephrine onto alpha and beta receptors at their effector tissues. Again, effector tissues of visceral control would be cardiac muscle, smooth muscle, and glandular tissue. Now, in addition to this completely neuronal component, the sympathetic division also has a hormonal component where the preganglionic fiber innervates the adrenal medulla. The adrenal medulla releases the hormones epinephrine and norepinephrine, right? And again, largely epinephrine. And it can then travel via the bloodstream to a whole host of target cells expressing, again, alpha and beta adrenergic receptors. Finally, the parasympathetic division, preganglionic motor neurons leave the central nervous system. Synapse within ganglia that are much closer to the target tissue, generally essentially embedded within the target tissue. Again, the ganglion look exactly the same, essentially, right? Releasing acetylcholine, our target receptors are nicotinic. We get activation of our postganglionic, much shorter now, postganglionic cell to release, in this case, acetylcholine onto muscarinic receptors. So muscarinic cholinergic receptors would be mediating our parasympathetic effects, as opposed to norepinephrine and epinephrine mediating our sympathetic effects.